Are you looking for a way to keep all of your job applicants in one place? But beyond that, also give them a way to interact with that information and see the process of the application itself? Well, if so, you are in the right place because that is exactly what we're going to be talking about in this video. We will be using a template from Softr that allows us to go step by step to follow along in the job application process. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. One of our favorite no-code tools is Softr.io. Softr is an incredible platform that allows you to basically build no-code web apps, and as the name would suggest, without even using a single line of code. And in this particular video, we're going to be breaking down a specific template that Softr's already made available for applicant tracking. Before we get into it though, I'd like to invite you to follow along inside of your own Softr account. The link for this particular template will be shared wherever you found this video, so you can go ahead and start using this template from scratch. But in addition to that, as a back end to Softr, we need a place to store the data. And for us in this example, we're gonna be using Airtable. If you're new to Airtable, you will also greatly benefit from our free Airtable crash course. The link for that crash course will also be shared around where you found this video, or you can check it out at garethpronovost.com/airtable-crash-course. That crash course is entirely free and will teach you the fundamentals of Airtable so that you're no longer overwhelmed by all this database mumbo jumbo. Without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into the heart of the video. We're gonna get started by installing this template, but first I wanna just explore the template a little bit and see what it's all about. So go ahead and pop on in here. You can find this template, as I said, using the links around this video, or you can just go to Softr.io and browse their template library. Now, once you're inside here, we can take a look and just see kind of generally what this looks like. It's gonna run on desktop, tablet, and mobile device, and we can't really see much of what's going on in this particular image, but we can scroll down, check out some different features and functionality of the template. So we can create job opportunities within the application. Applicants can view and manage new job applicants. We can also view actions, so team members can view their particular actions, leave notes, track applicants. Of course, as it's true with all of Softr, we have a responsive design for mobile, desktop, etc. And we can see the applicant CVs and bios, and even search and filter functionality within the application. So that's an awful lot of functionality inside of this app that's already been built for us. And of course, the advantage to using Softr, because it's a no-code platform, we can make tweaks to the template as we install it. So let's go ahead and install the template. And we just start by moving on here and saying use template. Now this of course presupposes that you have a Softr account. So if you're not already set up in Softr, go ahead and start your own account, and we'll include links around here as well so that you can get started with that. Now once we're inside here, you're gonna see a deeper dive on what the template looks like. On the right-hand side of the screen, we can scroll through different pages of the template. So here's the applicant tracking platform. We can see here, although it's a little hard to see, the nav bar up at the top is gonna have different things for open roles, adding new roles, viewing applications or applicants, and then my actions. So we can scroll through and kind of see all these different pages and just get a general understanding of how this template's gonna work. Now, once we're happy with the template, moving on from here, we're gonna simply say, use template. Now, the next part here is it's gonna say, do we wanna use Airtable or do we want to use Google Sheets? This is an important delineation. This is a new feature just added by Softr not too long ago, where you no longer have to keep your data in Airtable on the back end. You can now have your data living on the back end in Google Sheets as well. So imagine that if we use Google Sheets, we could keep all of our data there and still have the front end functionality of the Softr web app. Now for our example, as I already mentioned at the beginning of the video, we will be using Airtable. So we'll make that selection here, and we are now going to get the opportunity to create a copy of the back-end structure. So, of course, the data schema is where the raw data that powers the app is going to live, and we're choosing it to live in Airtable, but first, we have to sync up our Airtable account. We do that by grabbing our Airtable API key. Now, if you've not ever done this before, you can go on into your Airtable account, and in the upper right corner, find your account persona here, scroll on down to account, and once we make that selection, it'll open up in a new tab, and we can select our Airtable API key. So the Airtable API key is going to be in the Developer Hub section, and we can find it here by clicking. And of course, it's going to take us just a moment to load up that new page. Also note that you can start creating tokens. The older version of the API will no longer be available after January 2024. So depending on when you set this up, you can just create a token. This is the newer way of syncing up with third-party software. For now, I'm going to use my old API key, which will lose functionality in about a year after filming this video. So I'll go ahead and make that selection. Of course, this key is very private. You don't want to share it anywhere, but I'll copy it, flip on back now to my softer setup, and I will paste that API key here inside of my softer template. And immediately, softer knows that I've given it a valid Airtable API key, and it takes me to the next step. Now it's asking me to copy this base into my Airtable account. So this database doesn't currently exist. I'm going ahead and just with a simple click or two, I'm going to install the backend data schema inside of my Airtable. So here I am, I choose the workspace I want to send it to, and I say add base. Once it's done, it's going to take just a moment or two, it will open up that base. Now inside of this base, let's close down the side pieces here. We notice here that we've got a little README. How should I use the applicant tracking system? I love this feature because it really allows us to take our understanding of the template to the next level. But you can see here on the left-hand side, we have three key tables. We have applicants. These are obviously people who are putting in an application. We see also that those are linked to another table where it says applying for, and this is the position that the applicant is applying for. So we have different positions listed here. And then we also have interviewers in our third and final table. And so on this one, we have a name, we see the photo of the interviewer, what type of interview they're conducting it looks like, whether it was on site or phone, and of course the email address of the interviewer. So it would stand to reason that the people who are accessing the system might be our applicants. They might also be our interviewers. Now that we have an understanding of what we're tracking here and how our data lines up, let's flip on back into Softr to take a look at the application. So back inside of Softr, it's now simple enough. Softr already knows that we've copied that Airtable base. All we have to say now is create application. Now this particular step is going to take just a little bit of time as well because it's taking that template in Softr and recreating it in our Softr account. But you see, it wasn't all that much time in total. It came together pretty quickly, and now we can start diving into the actual no-code application inside of Softr. So I'll close down the tutorial, it's not my first time here, and I'm going to go over to Pages to explore the navigation of this application. So here we are on the home page, and we can see that on the home page, as you would expect, we have to sign in order to access anything. So this is the applicant tracking system by Softr. Explore the template with, and it's giving us currently one person to log into as an interviewer. And so my guess is that maybe our applicants can't actually log into the system. It's only our interviewers who are able to log in and actually see all the applications, who they have to interview next, and what the status of the various jobs are. So let's take a look. We have add job. On this particular page, we notice that we have a form where we can put in a job title and a location, a job description, detailed description, and required experience. So presumably, this would then add a record to our available jobs, and we could then see who applies for that position as it is linked to people who are actually applying as well. Going back to Pages, we can take another look at applicant details. This is going to be a drill down on the applicant table. So we get an image of the applicant, also their core information such as email and phone number. We have their CV or their resume uploaded here, including their cover letter and a breakdown of their experience as well. Pretty cool solution so far. Let's flip into some more pages. We see our applicants. Note that this is not the detail page, but all applicants in general. And so here we're looking at the various folks inside of our system that have applied for different jobs. We also see that they're tagged with either no hire, hire, or decision needed. So this is really nice. We see that as people apply for our roles, we can kind of track the status of those applicants and get to know them a little bit better. Of course, if we drill into them, that's how we get that updated detail page. Now, some other pages we might see, of course, are kind of standard things like, I forgot my password, how do I get that back, reset my password, what happens if I sign in or fail to sign in appropriately. But I also want to check out this My Actions section. So My Actions here is where applicants have been assigned to us. So presumably, as an interviewer who is accessing this application, I will see the folks that have been assigned to me and I can kind of track them through the process since the ball is now in my court to hold an interview and make a decision on that applicant. So prior to publishing our application, of course, we want to make sure that we have a user so that we can test this out from the user perspective once we publish the application. So let's take a look at doing that. On the left-hand panel here, we're gonna click on Users, and we see that we have a user here, but she does not have a magic link. So Lucy has been added with a fake email address, but let's actually create a magic link for Lucy so that we can access this application once we publish it. Once we're happy here, we're gonna go ahead and in the upper right corner, hit Publish to publish our app and publish any updates since the last time we published, or if this is your first time publishing, hit it for the first time. Now, we are able to access the live version of the app, and if we want to sign in as an interviewer, in this case Lucy, all we have to do is access that magic link. I'm going to go ahead and copy this and open up a new window, paste in that link, and hit enter to access the application from Lucy's perspective. Now, if we recall, before going too far down this rabbit hole, if we flip back into Airtable and we look at our interviewers, we will see that Lucy is one of those interviewers with the email address that was shared inside of the app. So as we add new people to our application, of course, we would do that inside of Softr, and they would also be added to Airtable. They would only be able to access the things that are unique and specific to them within the applicant tracking process. So, again, just as a reminder, flipping back into Softr, this is Lucy's specific experience. So, inside of here, on Lucy's homepage, she can flip into Jobs, Applicants, Hiring Managers, or My Account. We can also use the nav bar up here at the top. So, if Lucy wanted to view some open roles, simply click on in here, and Lucy now sees the current jobs that are still available. A Chief Creative Officer, Chief Decision Officer, etc. Now, it's also possible, of course, for Lucy to add a new job. So she simply clicks here and adds a new job. New job test, brief description. In this particular case, I will leave the location blank and add a new job. And just like that, we should see that new job test added to our list. Now, after adding the job, if we scroll on down, we don't actually see it here in our list. So we might have to kind of reverse engineer what's happening here. If we flip now back into Softr and we flip over to our pages, we can drill down into the jobs page. Now, if we click on the actual job block here, which is the block where we added a new job, but we didn't immediately see it, we can see here on the right-hand side that the default view is approved positions. So this gives us a clue as to what's happening on the back end. If we flip into Airtable now and we look at our positions table and we look and see we have two different views. One view is saying all positions, one view is saying approved positions. If we flip into approved positions and we look at the filter, what we notice is that the approved element inside of the data source says that the job has been approved. Now, we just created this new job and we did not approve it yet. So we do see inside of Airtable that yes, this job was added, new job test. But if we open this up and we look at the approved status here, let's go ahead and find it. We have this little approved single select dropdown where it's either approved, pending, or declined. Well, because we haven't approved it yet, it's not showing up in our Softr app. So this is a failsafe. It allows people to access the app on the front end. The interviewers can add new positions, but they don't automatically get added until an admin comes in and actually approves that particular job. Now that I've just done this, that is going to be immediately reflected inside of Sofdr. So if I flip back into the live version of the app and I refresh my page, we will see that we're going to pull in that latest job as well. So now here we go, scroll on down, here's new job test. I can drill into this now, and this is the job details page. I really like what this is doing. It's adding on the right-hand side of the screen the ability to drill into this. So it's not like I'm actually going to a new page entirely. It's like a pop-up page inside of the application, which I absolutely love. So here it is. I put in this terrible description when I started and created this, but I can update the job specifics. And by doing this, I can say new specs here, required experience, 5 years of blah. And let's go ahead and update. All of that information will be showing up now on the specifics of this particular job application. So that's at a high level how we're going to create new jobs and drill into those various jobs as well to see the information about what we're looking for. So here you can see a fully filled out one with a quick description, a bullet point job spec, and then required experience. We also then can scroll on down and look at the applicants who are linked to this particular job and probably even drill in on them in an additional modal here by focusing in on that particular application. So here we go. We see that this applicant applied on this date. Here's their information, their cover letter. We can drill into their resume, which of course we actually have access to, so we can download it just as I've done and open up that resume. And so you see we have a lot of possibility here, all of this information being stored locally inside of this application. Now, let's drill on back into the jobs portion here. If I scroll back up to the top, not only looking at my open roles, but also adding a new role. This is going to be very similar to adding a job as we just did on the last page. Although in this particular form, we're getting the detailed description and the required experience all in one place. I can also look at the applicants here as well. This is a list of all the different applicants. As we talked about earlier, I can filter by stage in terms of, are they being interviewed? Is a decision needed? Did we choose to hire? Did we pass and not hire? We can also search by name here. If I wanna like zoom in on just Cameron, start typing Cameron, and it will shorten the list of folks who are actually coming back here based on whatever I filtered by. And we can also then drill into my actions. And again, this is where we're going to see the applicants that are listed below that have been assigned to us as interviewers. And so here I see the different details of the folks that I held interviews with. I can also drill in on the details of that particular interview and see the applicant information here on the right side of my screen. Also, if I drill on down here, I can see the actual score of the applicant's interview, and I can also update the applicant stage here. And by simply hitting that button, I can choose if we're going to still change the status here, change them to interviewing, decision needed, whatever the case may be. So this is going to help you actually go through the process, post job applications for new available roles, accept applications for various applicants, and then track them through the applicant process as you saw here. I know we went pretty fast in this video. There's a lot to cover anytime we look at a Sofdr template because they're just so robust, but I hope you got a ton of value out of it. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them around where you found this video. And in the meantime, keep on building.